This hypothetical cross-section represents 100 million years of sediment accumulation, tectonism, and volcanism. First, to orient you, let's look at what's on the surface. This lake, which is cut down through the surrounding sedimentary bedrock, is near a volcanic dome that is surrounded by fallout deposits. We'll remove the foreground to expose the cross-section again. In general, young rock layers overlie older rock layers. Gaps in the sequence called unconformities are due to erosion, absence of deposition, folding, or faulting. We'll start with a layer of undeformed, slowly subsiding bedrock that gets drowned by a broad sea. Most sedimentary rock is produced by two broad processes. First, by the accumulation of weathered rock debris that was distributed by water, wind, and gravity. Second, though less abundant, rock is produced by precipitation, which is a chemical reaction where calcium carbonate and/or silica settle out of solution, forming limestone or chert. Both processes result in sedimentary rock strata with varying quantities of organic matter. The seas recede and the layers are subjected to regional compressive forces, which deform the strata. Slowly, wind-blown sediment blankets the area. After millions of years of continued sediment accumulation, regional extension stretches the plate until it drops along faults in basin range fashion. During extension, magma rises from the mantle and lava erupts on the surface. Normal faulting, accompanied by large earthquakes, offset the lava during continued extension. Sediment, eroded from highlands out of view, creates an angular unconformity over the faulted layers. An invading inland sea precipitates limestone. Renewed extension causes faulting. Multiple processes contribute to the accumulation of sedimentary strata. Broad uplift due to renewed extension is accompanied both by downcutting as well as by the slow rise of magma below the thinned crust. An explosive volcanic eruption through the lake and dome building punctuates its history.